Right, I want to talk about this gentleman right here. His name is Reuben Israel, and I just found out right now, I didn't even know this, that he passed away in 2021. And Reuben Israel was a street preacher who basically went around, for the most part of what you see on the internet, and told everybody that they were gonna go to hell if they didn't clean up their life. So that was his shtick, I guess, what he was really popular for. I did not agree at all with the way that Reuben Israel preached at all, because that's not in the Bible. Now, hold on a second. Jesus did go and tell the hypocritical Pharisees that they couldn't escape the judgment of hell because of the way that they were. But Jesus, nor Paul, nor John the Baptist went around and spoke like this guy did to people. I mean, to me, it was so vile the way that he would talk to people. It was such a distortion of the way that you're supposed to transmit the gospel to somebody. There was no real good news when it came to Reuben Israel and his street preaching, as far as you can tell online. Basically his big thing was telling everybody that they're going to hell. But when you look at the gospel and the way it was preached and to whom it was preached to, it wasn't done like that. It wasn't done like that. And again, the only people that Jesus told that they were in judgment was the hypocritical Pharisees. Jesus didn't go around preaching like that to everybody. And the slang, the words that Reuben Israel used, it was such vile words. I'm not going to repeat them here, but it's basically slang terms for people who are homosexual or whatever, this or that or whatever. He would call them those words. And it was just vile to me. It was not showing the fruits of the spirit. It was not showing any wisdom behind it. There, it was a wisdomless way to share Jesus Christ and the Bible to anybody. It just makes people in basic psychology want to revolt against him. Because if you go up and you're pounding on somebody with this vileness, they're naturally going to bark back. So it's just a natural basic psychology thing to it. And, he didn't have the wisdom to figure that out. I understand there has to be a balance in preaching and teaching between understanding hell and understanding grace, but there was not an equal balance when Reuben Israel went out there and spoke to people. I honestly believe that Reuben Israel could have possibly, if it was possible to know and add up some scientific way, I think it's very possible that he did more damage to actually sharing the gospel with people and tarnishing the image of the Bible and Jesus Christ than he did good. And I truly believe that. I truly believe that the way he was, because people are looking at you. You're the ambassador, so they're looking at you for God. And when you do it like him, you just do more harm than good a lot of times. And it's really sad. Luckily, God doesn't depend on Reuben Israel or me or anybody else to save somebody. Sure, we can be a part of that, but God is gonna eventually get what he wants to get done. So again, I'm not trying to bash the deceased. I think it's very sad that Reuben Israel died. I think that God will use anything and everything. Even though I know that Reuben Israel did it the wrong way lots of times, God still will use it, definitely for something. But honestly, like I said, again, going back to what I was saying, is that I think that Reuben Israel did just as bad of a job as you could possibly do in sharing what is called the good news. Because Reuben didn't go out there as if he had good news. Reuben made people who didn't know anything about God or Jesus or the Bible turn away farther than they were probably already because of the vileness of the way that he did what he did. So
nothing going on here, people. Keep walking. Nothing going on. Just you that's going to burn in hell. No big thing. Keep moving. Hit straight ahead.